you believe that it's already Thanksgiving time again? I feel like this year just flew by. First, welcome to my channel, or welcome back to my channel. My name is Stephanie. I'm Long Island's eating disorder specialist, and I post on this channel twice a week all about eating disorders, body image issues, and general mental health. If any of that is interesting to you or you think it could be helpful, please click the subscribe button down below. And while you're at it, definitely I would encourage you to subscribe to my email list. When you subscribe to my email list, every week at the beginning of the week, you will get an insight into what is coming up that week for you. And I will include any resources that I create to go in conjunction with my videos so that you can get the most out of each and every one of my videos. And of course, I will also include in there some cool announcements and collabs that are coming up that week. And it's something that I think you'll be really excited for. So definitely make sure that you subscribe to the email list using that link below. And of course, if you're watching this video at a later date, you can absolutely access whatever it is for this particular video. If you are interested in that, then what you need to do is subscribe to the email list. You'll get a welcome email. You can reply to that email with whatever video you're watching and resource you're looking for, and I will absolutely get that over to you. If you would like a daily dose of inspiration, definitely check out my Instagram. I will leave that link in the description below. If you like this video at the end, I would greatly appreciate it if you gave it a thumbs up. Thanksgiving can be an absolutely wonderful time and a wonderful holiday, but for those struggling with eating disorders, it could be a time of chaos, of stress, and fear and anxiety. So what I hope I can help you out with today is how we can find the very purpose of Thanksgiving, which is expressing gratitude, how we can use that in the Thanksgiving season so that we can really get through it, one, not only in one piece, but to really enjoy the season this year. You may have had many seasons prior that was filled with your eating disorder and filled with a lot of anxiety, and I want this season and this holiday to be different for you. I bet you would like that too. Leave a comment down below if that is something that you are hoping for this year. And I really want to open this up. If any of you have any questions or concerns about this holiday season, please, please leave a comment down below with whatever that is. Or if you want to remain more anonymous, definitely DM me on Instagram with whatever it is, and I will do my best to make a video about it, because chances are, if you are struggling with it, others are as well. And I want to make sure I'm tailoring this to help you. There are two very stressful parts of Thanksgiving. First, it's family and social gatherings that tend to occur on the holiday or around the holiday or both. And of course, the second part of it is food. So let's start with family and social gatherings. That could be really, really overwhelming for someone who struggles with an eating disorder or disordered eating, chronic dieting, whatever. You could put whatever it is that you're struggling with in that phrase. Whenever I say eating disorders, whatever it is for you, that's something that could be a major thing for someone struggling. If this sounds like you, some of the things that you may be concerned about is that maybe your family doesn't have the most impeccable and polished way to express thoughts, or maybe they don't realize that there is a filter that they could use that they choose not to. And many times you'll hear that. I know a lot of family members comment about people's body sizes, which I really want to understand when the hell that ever was appropriate, because it certainly isn't now. I mean, I don't know why people comment so much on other people's body sizes, but anyway, I'm going on a tangent. So we all have those family members who do that, and you may feel a lot of resentment toward that family member for bringing things up for you, or just a lot of discomfort around that family member. And more often than not, I'm not going to say this is 100%, because I know that there are some people who have family members that are really just not well-intentioned, but for the most part, most family really does want the best for each other. And they may not realize that what they're doing and saying is actually causing destruction for you. So how can we use gratitude for this? For instance, maybe you say your grandmother, she always comments about your body, and she will always comment no matter what it is, no matter if she thinks that you're thinner, if she thinks that you're bigger, she will make it known whatever she thinks. And you have resentment toward her, or maybe you just don't want to be around her, or maybe you try your best to avoid her. And of course, that relationship is hurting because of it. So how can you switch that to gratitude? How can you recognize that your grandmother, whatever her intentions are, is there a way that you could flip it? Is there a way that you can look at your grandmother and instead of feeling resentment and anger, is there a way that you can look at her and say, you know what? I'm so grateful that she's able to be here. I'm so grateful that I've had the experience of getting to know a lady who has so many interesting stories. I'm so grateful that my grandmother, no matter how many inappropriate or inappropriate comments she makes, that she loves me so, so much. How can you switch that to gratitude? How can you find gratitude in the family gathering, in the fact that you have so many family members that can be there and to get together and that love each other? I really hope that you can challenge yourself to find gratitude in it. And that doesn't mean that all of a sudden the resentment or the anger is going to completely turn away and never come back again. But at the very least, for the moment that we're expressing gratitude and feeling gratitude, there's going to be an absence of the other emotions. And two, is it really can be something that changes the entire dynamic. While you can appreciate and recognize that what she's saying isn't the best, we can still find gratitude in the fact that she's there. So how can that work for you? I really want you to challenge yourself to think about that. And of course, the other part is food. So as you know, most people before their Thanksgiving meal say some sort of grace. Usually that's a prayer if you believe in God. If not, you may just say thank you to one another or whatever that might look like for you. And this is something that I would like for you to really, really take in for yourself. How can you go through the entire season? Sometimes I know Thanksgiving lasts a few days for some people and everything has changed up because usually you might not have the breakfast that you normally have and you have snacks throughout the day. And you know, then grandma brings over a different type of pie that you're kind of intrigued by, but you're afraid to eat and all of this stuff. How can you look at all of this and find gratitude in every single part of it? Can you find gratitude that you have the means to have an abundance of snacks at the ready? Can you find gratitude that your mom always buys your favorite cheese to put on the crackers? Can you find gratitude in the fact that your aunt makes the best potatoes? Can you find gratitude in all of these things? And can you then use it and put that energy toward the food, looking at it? And maybe you might not want to say this out loud, but I would encourage you to do so. But if not, at least looking at it, saying, you know what, I'm so appreciative of this food. I'm so appreciative of you. I'm so appreciative that you could fill my stomach. And I know that might be a little uncomfortable for me, but regardless, I am appreciative of this food and what it can do for me and what it nourishes me with and how tasty it can be for me. Again, shifting whatever emotional experience that we're having around our families or the relationships around us or the food to gratitude, it is so, so powerful. When we are able to experience gratitude, it makes it, at least for that moment, as I said before, where you're not experiencing the other emotions. And I hope that this can help turn your season around and really turn Thanksgiving around for you. I really hope that you can help make it a good Thanksgiving for you, filled of gratitude, filled with family, and filled with good food, because that is really the intention behind the entire holiday. I hope that you found this video helpful. If you did, give it a thumbs up. I would greatly appreciate it. Leave a comment down below about what your favorite Thanksgiving dessert or food is. I absolutely love the string bean casserole that we always make. So it's so delicious. What is yours? Leave a comment down below. You can click my face over here to subscribe to my channel. And I wish you a very, very happy and grateful Thanksgiving on your journey to finding your state of balance. And I will see you in my next video.